the sun-drenched tropical paradise of Isle Delfino. We're so pleased to welcome you to our beautiful home. Come enjoy a natural wonderland, to which we've added the world's finest resort facilities, a spectacular amusement park, and succulent seafood. Whoa. All this and more await you on Isle Delfino. Come relax and let us refresh your body and spirit.
Man, I gotta stop taking so long to get to these Mario playthroughs. But either way, I'm Super Mario Sonic Lover, and welcome to Mario Sunshine. This has been quite a long time coming, and I also have Scrappy along here with me today as well.
Hi, folks. My throat's a little messed up from sucking on some ice right now.
Oh, okay. Basically, just to refresh on like how I'm doing Mario playthroughs as of right now, I'm going 3D platformer, then one of the new Super Mario Bros. Games, and kind of alternating between them. I have no idea what I'm gonna do with Mario Bros. 2 on the 3DS, but I'll think about that when it's more around the time of that, but... Yeah, Mario Sunshine. This is a pretty divisive... This is probably the most divisive 3D Mario. It's gonna be an interesting one, for sure. We'll get more into the specifics, but... it's a game that I've personally grown to enjoy more and more over recent years. So, you know... Mysterious. Also, the guy just yelling in the background.
I am most concerned with the well-being of the princess in this dreadful heat. Master Mario, if you would, cross over to that shore and find some assistance.
Also, one of the only Mario games that has voice acting, for what it's worth. It's kind of charmingly bad. But I kind of enjoy
Piata,
it.
Piata!
Huh?
Piata's dead!
Yeah, there's a lot of Piantas that just get stuck in the goop. So this is our main, gimmick for the game, I guess. I don't feel comfortable calling it that, but either way. Also, you can see, like, previous games in the corner, that's pretty cool.
I am Flood, a flash liquidizer ultra-dousing device. I hope to be of assistance. Proceeding with user instruction. Use the R button to shoot water from my tank.
Yeah, so, starting with... I think...
The R button all the way down, you can stop and shoot.
Sunshine and Galaxy, both have, like, direction. Partner character, if you will, like this game has Flood and Galaxy games have the Luma, and they don't really do that again until Odyssey, I think. So I don't know, it's an interesting concept giving Mario like a buddy character and give you like more options to work with.
Enter a body of water and press the R button.
Excuse me. Didn't even occur to me that most of the 3D Marios give him a companion fairy, basically.
Yeah, I didn't really think about that too much until, like, just now, really, but... Yeah, like, Galaxy had the loom, which gives you the spin, which... simple in concept, but, like, that changes how you play the game a lot. And the same with, like, Flood here, like... you immediately have a lot more options with Flood at your disposal. And, I don't know, I really enjoy using Flood in this game, personally.
I'll say that, Piazza.
May as well. Let's just kill this guy first.
Piazza is happy to be alive.
Yeah. And somehow the goopy piranha plants can, like, make concrete just... go down a bit or something for some reason. Oh no. Yeah, this game tries a bit more with its story.
Quite an unusual device.
I don't know, it's kind of charming in a sense. There's a bit more to it than just Peach getting kidnapped, which doesn't even happen until, like, midway. Spoiler alert, I guess, but...
Court is now in session.
As you are no doubt aware, someone has been senselessly defacing Fair Isle Delfino using some paint-like substance. The accused is charged with polluting our beautiful home, and yes, endangering our very way of life. Indeed, how can one not be aware of what is going on? Though it is daytime,
I mean, we just landed, so...
Our poor residents tremble beneath a veil of darkness. Expert shine scholars have determined that this darkness has arisen because all of our guardians...
Is it a coincidence that the way the goop is looks like on the Shine Gate thing? Like, it looks like an evil face.
This horrible graffiti is to blame. Behold this sketch of the perpetrator based on eyewitness descriptions. The truth is obvious. The guilty party sits among us. It is none other than Mario.
Objection!
Overruled. I judge the defendant guilty as charged. I hereby order the defendant to clean this entire island until I...
Is that a male Piazza?
The judge?
Court adjourned.
I always thought that was female, to be honest. I'm not sure.
This appears to be quite a predicament.
Then confiscate Flood.
Yeah.
Inhabitants are indeed troubled.
I think they realized, like, we kind of need him.
The main problem. Mario, you witnessed this object at the airstrip, correct? It is a shine sprite. Shine sprites.
You're not stars, basically.
Power on Isle Delfino. They used to gather in great numbers at the Shine Gate, but the graffiti incident has polluted the island and most of the shine sprites have fled. There is no longer any power to support the peaceful lifestyle of the islanders. It is most pitiable. The only way to ensure the return of the shine sprites is to keep the island from becoming any dirtier. The perpetrator is likely at work even as we speak. And you, Mario, are being treated as a criminal. Tomorrow we must do our best to resolve this situation.
Sonic Adventure 2 nonsense.
Yeah, I was just about to say, like, it's kind of uncanny how similar the stories are between these two games. Like, unintentional or not. Because they both, like, have the main characters get framed for something they didn't do. And it just causes a huge mess. In SA2, I guess, like, it's more... of an accident, I suppose, because they just think that Shadow looks like Sonic, whereas this game is, like, deliberate. But either way, it's kind of funny how they have similar concepts in the story. What do you think about, like, Flood in general, like, character-wise and gameplay?
He? Is fine.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, get used to these piranha plant bosses, because they happen quite a lot at the for the first half of the game, and they don't really get any more difficult or interesting, honestly.
Look, on the statue's head.
Yeah, there's not much to say about them.
I'm Shadow the Hedgehog.
Oh, there's this funny image where you know how Sonic goes like, "Wow, he's fast!" But and then it's just Mario doing a backwards long jump glitch. Oh, it's so stupid.
At the rescue Peach, there is no time limit. There's no time limit here. You can take as long as you want.
Yeah. I don't know if the secret shrines are available right now, but. It'd be really funny if you could just ignore this completely and get some other shrines entirely. Hello. I like the guys that literally just say, "Oh, you saved me," and then they just like throw you in the air. There you are. Yeah, you can't hurt him when he's doing this.
So Mario literally enters. So in Super Mario 64, he enters into paintings. So now he's literally enter into paint.
Yeah. Oh. And yeah. Somehow it's a full world inside of them. Although unlike 64, these are all. Still part of the island, because, like, if I just go back, you look in the background here, there's invisible wall, so don't worry, you can see the second world down there, I think right in the far distance, that's Isle Delfino, there's Pinner Park, and just, I don't know, I like that the world is all interconnected, even if you can't, like, go from one level to another in one go. I do appreciate that they tried to make the world cohesive in that way. Because I know Double Dash did the same thing, where you can sometimes see courses in the background of others, and it's nice little attention to detail, just trying to make the world feel more believable.
This game had more cutscenes in its first 10 minutes than Odyssey had in its entirety.
Yeah. Yeah. You can tell, the GameCube era felt very... You can tell it felt really experimental. Like, the fact that Sunshine is trying to be a bit more daring with its story by Mario standards. The fact that Luigi's Mansion is a launch title and how different that is. For the series, Pikmin being the whole new concept, and like Wind Waker, putting Zelda in, huh?
Wind Waker being Wind Waker.
Yeah, like that. I kind of enjoy the bit GameCube for that because I kind of enjoy Nintendo the most when they're experimental because they try and let their creative juices flow and don't worry about sticking to. The norms as much. But on the other hand, there are quite a lot of people that aren't quite as fond of some of them, specifically this game. I don't know how your experiences with this game have been, but I used to be kind of on and off with this game. I enjoyed it for the most part growing up, but back then I kind of had similar mindsets of other people, and like I would much rather have played like the other 3D games at the time. Nowadays I'd have to think where I rank this compared to the other 3D games, but yeah, my opinion of this game has changed quite drastically since then, and I enjoy it quite a lot now. I don't know, what's your general like feelings towards the game? Like how did you what is this game to you basically?
excuse me. I didn't own it. I just rented it. My family rented it. My family rented it in 2004, and I definitely noticed the similarities, but also differences with Super Mario 64, which I also didn't own at the time, but had played at a cousin's house.
Okay.
It was definitely a weird Mario game. I was wondering why we had shine sprites instead of stars, and why Peach and Mario had short sleeves.
I didn't actually notice that until, like, someone, like, posted it, like, in an image. It was just like, oh, Sunshine is the only game, well, as far as I know, it's like the only game where Mario has like short sleeves. Like, oh yeah. kind of like that. Works with the setting.
That's Mario's vacation clothes, apparently.
Yeah.
Definitely asking the same thing adult me still asks to this very day, where the hell is Luigi?
Yeah. Like, because this game came out after Mario Sunshine, because, like, so, like...
After Luigi's Mansion?
Hmm?
This game came out after Mario Sunshine, but you mean after Luigi's Mansion?
Oh, yeah, that's right, man. This game came out after Luigi's Mansion, so, like, if we... Like, goodness knows what the actual Mario timeline is, but just imagine, like you just saved Mario from King Boo and all that in a fake mansion, and then he goes on vacation and he doesn't even take you with him. It's just like, how are you gonna treat your little bro like that? Seriously.
Depending on how, excuse me, regular piranha plants, or at least Isle Delfino variants, just covered in graffiti. The piranha plants, are those like regular quote-unquote piranha plants, or at least the Isle of Delfino variants just covered in graffiti?
I don't know, honestly. To be honest, I didn't even know there were piranha plants until someone brought it up, but most of us, most of the time when they appear, there should be like Piantas, like, all, like, swallowed up in the stuff and whatnot. Also, this is a 100%, by the way, so I'm gonna be going for all the, blue coins and all secret shrines.
All these years I thought those were, like, paint balls, but apparently it's piranha heads just rolling.
Yeah, I guess so. Like, they always, yeah, those things always weirded me out.
Buds, I guess they're just rolling.
Yeah. There's also like those little piranha enemies that come out of the goop itself. So, yeah, I guess that makes sense too. Yeah, the most danger out of these bosses, if you even want to call them that, are just the little guys that come out.
Some like jellyfish.
Yeah. Because the piranha plant doesn't even do any of attacks of his own. You literally have to jump into him to get hurt.
I worth noting you can pass by that shine sprite completely.
Yeah, I think...
It's like the second mission, I think.
Yeah, I think you can just skip the first mission and go right to the second one.
I sequence break that much later in the game, I know that.
Yeah, because like, the way this game works, it's quite a bit different to 64. Because in 64, you, for the most part, you could go to a stage and get any star you wanted. Unless something is proven otherwise, because sometimes there's requirements. But in this game, like, you do one episode, then you go to the next one, then the next one. And the only... You can only really get different shines for, like, the 100 shine sprite, 100 coin shine sprite, because those exist again.
Blue coins.
Yeah, or the secret shines. Most of the time, they're just red coin challenges. So, there isn't as much leeway. Not leeway, but you can't divert your path as much, especially for the fact that to get to the final stage, you're going to have to at least get to episode 7 for every level. So, it's a bit more linear than 64, which may be a good or bad thing depending on who you ask. I don't mind it too much because the way the game works is that the worlds change quite a bit, and it feels like there's an actual passing of time within each episode, and it makes it feel more like a breathing world, so I don't mind it as much. But if you liked 64 being flexible and like letting you just choose your own route more or less, you might be a bit disappointed. But I don't know.
Forgot how acrobatic Mario used to be.
Yeah. He's like the... It's either this or Odyssey where he's like the most acrobatic, because you can do a lot of cool stuff in this game. I'm trying to remember when certain things show up for blue coins.
I guess to get back on the topic of Luigi's, this game might actually be a prequel to Luigi's Mansion.
That makes more sense. That would make more sense.
I mean, it's still messed up that he left Luigi behind, but
I'd be able to forgive him a bit more if it happened after this game. Okay, I know for a fact like a graffiti letter shows up around here. That's not an M. But I don't know what chapter that happens in. I guess we'll just fight you, Piranha.
I'm just covered in so much gum in this game, it's nasty.
Yeah. Yeah. But you start with the hover nozzle, it's basically like... Well, it's basically exactly how it sounds, honestly. Don't need to really explain it much.
The cape from Mario World, but...
Kind of, yeah. It's the difference is just the fact that there is a limit. Also, there is a blue coin on this pillar.
He's Louise.
Yeah. A lot of blue coins is, like, basically just... spray at something that looks kind of suspicious.
Was there a curtain right there?
Huh?
By a curtain?
Curtain? I'm not sure.
The trees, I think. What the? I'm not gonna lie, I think those big boulder things actually being piranha plant heads kind of creep me out more.
Yeah, like, just the idea of that as well, like, it's, yeah, that sounds pretty terrifying.
Makes my skin crawl a little.
And get another blue coin. I believe there's 30 blue coins in every main stage.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. It's something, like, you kind of know, you might be able to, like, notice... I guess, but like, you can kind of tell that this game was a little bit rushed, in the sense that like, stuff with the blue coins especially makes it feel like there was supposed to be a lot more, and apparently they wanted, like 3 to 5 more worlds than we actually got. So, like, stuff with the blue coins, you can kind of, it kind of shows that they were just adding in some extra fluff so we can get that 120 shine quota.
Arbitrary number.
Yeah. It's just, like, it just doesn't feel right if you don't have that amount.
And this people is probably the most famous character introduced in this game aside from one other.
Yeah.
The Piranha.
Yep. I have to remind myself that he comes from this game sometimes.
Just Thirsty Harry.
He gets a refight that's a bit more difficult, but this is basically your first real boss of the game.
Slaps himself to get himself out.
Yeah. Yeah, he doesn't put out much of a fight here. Yeah, now that I think about it, the Galaxy games both start with a PT. Well, not a PT Piranha specifically, but.
Kind of morbid.
yeah, that is really disturbing. But. Yeah,
we'll never see him again, folks!
Nope, he's dead. Yeah. But, like.
Never see PT Piranha in any Mario game again.
I don't think. Like, we see, like, versions of a PT Piranha, but I don't think we see PT Piranha himself in the main series again?
Super Mario Brothers.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about- yeah, New Super Mario Bros., yeah. Right.
And yeah, I just realized, clearly someone in the 3D Mario team really likes the piranha plant species, because they- a lot of games.
Yeah. Also, going back to, like, 100 coins, they, like, really suck in this game, because if you don't pick the right, a good episode where a bunch of coins are around, you could potentially screw yourself over and, like, have, like, 90 and just barely not have enough. And, yeah, it's kind of annoying. So when you go for 100 coin shines, be sure that it's an episode where you can get enough coins in. Otherwise, you're just gonna be scouring around for hours, and it's.
Forget when you die in a level, your coin kind of resets or no?
That's how it was in 64. So I want to say yes, but I could be wrong.
On our luck, we'll have to, we're gonna find out soon enough.
I'd prefer not for that not to happen, but I guess we'll find out. Also, it's better to just do press continue instead of saving coin and you get blue coins, because it makes it a lot quicker. Because if you just keep saving every time, you have to have that load screen pop up. It doesn't take too long. But still, it can make the game flow much better. So, okay, there we go. I knew I wasn't going crazy. I knew there was a blue coin there at some point. How much of the did you ever like complete like get all the shrines, or like how much did you?
Absolutely not.
Yeah.
My family's journey with this game ended with the squid races.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you still have full damage, by the way.
Wait.
I think Galaxy stopped giving you full damage.
Sworn they had it too.
I don't remember. I know for a fact Odyssey doesn't. Like, you get stunned for a little bit, but that's it. I think there's a blue coin. It might be another episode. Yeah. Yeah, the blue coins are, like, really the only, like, well, that and the red coin challenges, I suppose, are, like, the only really, collector fun aspects, the major collector fun aspects of the game, really. Because besides that, again, it's, like, really linear, and, not a lot of ways to diverge the, normal path. If you will.
After reading Mario game, we've got some padding.
Yeah. I think 64 is the only 3D Mario that doesn't have, like, major padding. Like, because, like, 60, like, even the most I can really say would be, like, the blue, the, 100 coin stars, but I don't know. I don't know if I'd call that filler in the same way. I'm pretty sure there's a blue coin around here somewhere. Here's a question then. Do you prefer like 64s? Style, and I guess Odyssey by extension, where, like, you can basically just go wherever you want and get any star or moon from the beginning? Or do you prefer, like, a Sunshine or Galaxy, where you have to do the stars in a specific order, but they change the level each time?
It really depends on my mood.
Yeah, I can... Okay, there we go.
I mean, 64, it's kind of... It's nice of them to give you some freedom, but you're gonna get booted out of the level after you get each star, so it's a bit of a point.
Yeah. It's like, that's like the main thing that makes 64 hard to go back to. But even, they didn't even address it with 64DS, and by that point, they really should have known better. Like, sometimes it's a good idea to, not be, like, 100%, like the original. I mean, 64DS isn't really like the original, but still.
I mean, I think Nintendo thought of a feature, not a bug.
Yeah. Like, just imagine how tedious Odyssey would be if, like, you had to exit a stage every time you got a moon. And, like, considering how often you get them, like, that would just... Yeah, that would not be fun. So I'm glad they took the Banjo-Kazooie route with that one.
They fixed the bridge.
Yep. Oh, hi.
I'm gonna watch you to clean every Piazza, because that stuff's making me...
Ah, man. There are some episode-specific blue coins as well, which can be kind of annoying sometimes. I think that one's available forever, so we can get that later. We don't even have the right means to get up there right now, unless I do some speedrun tech, which I'm not going to do.
Oh, Mario sound effects sound like they were just ripped straight from 64. Those are Mario 64 sound effects.
I think they're new. It's hard to tell half the time.
And Charles is still kind of trying to nail the Mario voice.
Yeah.
You know, he's been doing it for a decade by this point.
Yeah. Oops.
I've suddenly realized why Pokies don't show up in 3D Mario games too often.
Yeah, they're awkward to hit, because, I mean, they weren't too bad in 64, especially since they gave you blue coins, but the ones in this game just feel really awkward for some reason. I don't really know why, but I don't know, so mostly, sometimes when I swear I hit them, like, I just get hit myself, like that. So I don't know. Or both happens. But thankfully they don't appear much, so it's not that big of a deal. Okay. Also, this is the first game that, fixed the wall jump, where instead of 64, like, basically you jump onto a wall and then if you don't jump again immediately after, like, you just like bonk on the wall and fall. So yeah, they instead of that happening, you just slide until like you jump, and which is a lot more, feels a lot more natural, and isn't as strict. So, yeah, it's a good change.
These are the parts that killed me as a kid.
Yeah, these are the harder parts of the game. Case in point, I was a bit too hasty on that.
Give you a taste of power with Flood and then they take it away.
Yeah. It just... It's kind of... I kind of like them in concept, though, because it's like you've grown so used to this new tool, and then it's just putting you into a platforming challenge more akin to something you might be seeing like some of the other games.
There's more platforming than 64 had proper, honestly.
That's true, yeah. But, I don't know, like, because, like, well, okay, so, like, Sunshine basically all the levels in the game, you have a design philosophy of, like, 64's more open levels, where there's, you just kind of explore a big open, open world with, not a lot of, verticality. I don't know how to explain it, but, like, something like, TikTok Clock or Rainbow Ride, where you, had a lot of linear platforming and stuff. That's all gone for the main areas. I should have went to the other level. That stuff's gone for the main levels. I may as well just get this done. We can go to the previous level for the secret after. But yeah. What was I gonna say?
Verticality and levels.
Right. I was talking. Yeah. In 64, there were some levels that were more exploration based and others that were more platform heavy, and this game basically splits those elements into two, whereas like the main levels are basically just these big open spaces with little to no bottomless pits, and then they have those secret rooms, if you will, that have like platforming stuff that you'd expect from Mario, and I think that was a smart move. I think that was overall a smart move, because 64 worked the best when it was doing the open world kind of thing, and when it went for something like TikTok Clock, it suffered a lot because it's basically asking you to climb the same clock over and over again because of the boot out system, and it makes it more tedious to complete like some levels than they should be otherwise, and like the levels that shined the most were the more open stages, because with the boot out system it doesn't feel as bad with those because it feels that you can explore the
first level. The terrain.
Yeah, you can traverse the terrain in different ways each time, whereas like TikTok Clock, you have to go up, you have to platform up the place the exact same way every time, and yeah, it can get a bit tiring. I swear there's like blue coins that appear somewhere around here.
Water effects in this game are great.
Yeah. The GameCube had, like, really good water. Like, Pikmin in this game, in specific... Oh, Wind Waker as well, but that's more stylized.
It better be good in that game, you're surrounded by it.
Yeah. And this game is, like, a tropical setting, and, like, there's water everywhere. I recognize that.
Pokemon Ruby and Sapphire came out in the Game Boy Advance. I think Nintendo just really liked water in the early 2000s.
Yeah, I guess so. How are you doing for blue coins?
Cool everywhere.
18. Yeah. I know there are like 2 blue coins we can't get yet here, so when we get to like 28, that's when I know we're done.
Redcon.
Yeah, this game really loves red coins for some reason. Because like this world has 2 mandatory ones. And 2 secret red coin challenges. And there's a bunch more. There's a bunch more later on in the game. I have no idea why they love red coins so much, but it is what it is.
I think there was some development struggles with this one.
Yeah.
You think that they would have had more? Given they didn't release this on launch year like most Mario platforms at the time.
Yeah. Yeah, because again, like Luigi's Mansion was the launch game, and
Children, once upon a time, Mario platforms did launch the console.
Yeah, and when did this game come out? Like 2002?
It's 2002.
Okay. And it's kind of funny then, because Galaxy came out 2007, which was like a year after the Wii came out, so. I guess it's just. Hold on a second. Did the GameCube come out in 2000 or 2000 or 2001?
2001.
Okay. So I guess the GameCube and the Wii, they both just got a Mario game like a year after the console came out. Probably unintentional, but whatever.
And he was busy with other things at the time. Yeah.
I guess, thinking about it, honestly, I guess I can understand, I guess the red coins kind of make sense, like considering like the open kind of design, I guess they just wanted to make use of the space and make you explore it a bit, because like the blue coins that I've been looking for are completely optional, so I can understand them wanting to use the red coins to make it so you need to look around a bit.
So. There was a ledge grabbing mechanic in this game.
Yeah. It's, not really reliable, though, so most of the time it's best to just jump on the platform.